you might actually have the opportunity to be near Barbra Streisand, and then
this is the closest offering I'll ever get to Barb's.
Now that you have all these minds in your band and you're set as a band, does that change down the road how you're approaching stuff?
I still write, do a lot of the writing stuff. But no, I mean, it's nice, like, we're still in really early days with the new album, but I think it's going to be a much more collaborative project.
You guys wound up at that abandoned amusement park in Berlin. How did you get in there?
We saw it, like, oh, we found this like hidden gem, and then like a month later, the XX held a festival there.
Shit.
You're like, oh.
A little bit late
not
on that
so,
one,
not
Matthew.
So hidden, is it? In Berlin, we went to this. We did a sort of session in this amazing little cafe. The cafe is all like kind of old vintage furniture and stuff, and then you went into a cupboard and down the stairs. Through a bookcase into this basement, and there's like a club down there.
Cool.
Wicked. But if you close your eyes,
I saw that you also hung out with Frank Ocean briefly. Was that a thing for you? Were you like stoked to, or was it just like, oh, there's Frank Ocean?
Oh, you were pleased.
Photo.
He was pleased.
Hung out's a strong time.
Yeah, okay.
Dan sort of like pounced like some sort of lion.
But the only award show I've ever been to, which is the Brits at the end of it all.
Frank just kind of got separated from the herd slightly.
Saw Frank Ocean, and he was having his photo taken with this English pop star, which I thought was quite like just the incongruity of it. I thought was pretty funny.
Who was the pop star?
It doesn't matter.
Okay.
But I was taking photos. I was just because I'd had a couple of drinks. I was like, this is hilarious. So I started taking photos. Frank Ocean turns like pointed at me. What? He was like, have no fear. And I was like, I couldn't figure out what he meant, and I was really freaking out. So I ended up
just a couple of drinks.
The natural response was to be like, another photo. So we took a photo together, and I started talking to him about his music, and then realised he probably wasn't interested. That's why you should never meet people who you admire.
I know that also from scouring your Instagram that you guys are fans of Jameson and drinking in general. Which city produced the nastiest hangover?
Well, on this tour,
oh.
LA, maybe? Where else?
Chicago broke me.
Chicago, yeah. Actually, Berlin, I sorry to keep talking about Berlin, yeah. That was quite a big night. In Paris, we were...
Oh.
I'm a bit obsessed with this film director called David Lynch, and he's got a club.
No way.
Paris, yeah. But he sort of, it's like six stories underground. And it's really weird. It's like a really pretentious members club. But it looked amazing. And this was very cool. And we had.
I tried absinthe for the first time.
Oh.
And then I went and had a little nap in the toilet.
You...
A little sick and then a nap next to him.
Oh, good. Did you see any fairies that appeared?
No, it's just don't. You can't drink absinthe responsibly, it turns out.
Thanks for watching, and while you're at it, why don't you check out some of our other videos? You can click that video right there, or subscribe to our channel.
I think we've lost all of our friends in the 4 years.
I had two friends, and now they're gone.
It's just tragic. New age, to the new
age, whoa. What was the best prank that they pulled?
Probably, had a poo in our bin. Disgusting people.